Dumb Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now, of course, we're going to talk some Fury and Deontay Wilder, actually. You know, that's the fight on February 22nd. But it's one thing that we're not paying attention to. You know, especially, you know, me being pessimistic about what's going to happen in the boxing year of 2020. I told you in January, it's going to suck. And my reason being, not that it won't be a good fight here or there, but in no division will we get undisputed. That's a bad thing to know at the beginning of the damn year. Then know all these weight divisions, and we got a bunch of them nowadays. I forgot how many, just a whole bunch of weight divisions. There ain't none of them, especially starting at lightweight going up. And I did it at the beginning of the year. Show you, ain't nobody going to be undisputed, right? So, you know, no, I wasn't happy about the damn fight with Fury and Wilder. I was hoping that it would be Joshua and Wilder, right? Joshua wins the fight against Ruiz and says right after that fight, boom, forget everything. I want Wilder now. And that's what would have happened. Fury would have had to wait, and so would Pulev or Usyk or whoever else. But we talked about that. That would have been the perfect case scenario. But Joshua would have had to say that. Everybody on sanctioned bodies would have backed off. But okay. My little last little glare of hope. You know what I'm saying? Last little glare of hope that I got for the fight. You know what I'm saying? That it could happen. We could get undisputed. You know what I'm saying? That's if Anthony Joshua comes to the damn fight with Fury and Wilder and gets in the ring. Let me tell you something. At that point, it would be on. You could save the day in boxing. Matter of fact, that the trilogy match for whoever won that fight with Fury and Wilder has to wait. Everybody would go undisputed. Matter of fact, if you hadn't fought Pulev, then what that they would say, hold up on that. You know, everybody, the whole boxing world would at least believe that we can get undisputed. Everybody. You know how much, do you know how many what would go down if Joshua were to show up to that fight? That would be the biggest side story. The camera would be on him all the time. You know what I mean? And that people would start believing that he wanted to fight, to have that fight. You know what I'm saying? Then if you step in the ring, it'll make it even more. You know what I'm saying? Boom. You know, I got to win. Let's say Wilder won. Yo, Wilder, I want you now. Fury, you got to wait for the trilogy. Vice versa. We're going to do this fight right now. Matter of fact, people be like, well, man, Pulev, man, whatever. We'll get to Pulev who gets the winner. And if you have to fight somebody in the meantime, which anybody in them, Ortiz is standing over there, but nobody want to do that. Just something like that to help everyone believe that a fight will happen. Right? We only are judging Joshua by his actions. You know what I'm saying? It's like, damn, that would be a perfect opportunity. Eddie Hearn right now talking about, hey, the winner has to fight Joshua, knowing that these guys have a trilogy. Right? Knowing they're contractually bound to have a trilogy. So why would you even say that? So don't say it. Send Joshua there. That is what a contract would say, shut up. Everybody, because the boxing world would be like, whoa, the arena would go crazy. If Joshua showed up there, just showed up. If he get in the ring, it'd be awesome. And Joshua tell him, you know, something, you know, hey, mate, all this time, you've been thinking I don't want to fight you. I want you now, right now. And it's on. That would be huge. You know, but the actions are always not. We don't even ask him to go. I've said that in many videos. We don't, nobody even asking Joshua to go. They know he ain't going, right? And then, you know, when Deontay Wilder wanted to come there, you know, hey, what? I don't want him to come. I don't need to hype a fight that's not signed. That's what the point is. I'm coming to let you know what your opponent wants to do. We can have the fight. You know what I'm saying? That's what this has to happen. Right? Most fighters, you got to restrain them from going to the fight against the dude that they want to fight so bad. You got to restrain them. Demetrius Andre, he can't go nowhere near Canelo Alvarez. They done banned him from coming to any press conferences or anything. So is Gennady Golovkin. They came security for this dude with a wanted sign. He can't even go nowhere near him. So he can keep him like from not doing it. You know what I mean? So the opportunity is there. This is something that I think Joshua fans should right now be talking about. You know, you got a few days. Hey, Joshua, man, go on over there and say something. Eddie Hearn, while he's in there saying, hey, everybody needs to fight Joshua, this and that. Go there. It's a big, big opportunity. The world is watching. That's a huge fight. And if Joshua wants him next, we don't have to be talking about Pulev. He can go right there and get what he wants. Or at least the respect and have the anticipation that people want to see the fight again, and that people think that you really want the fight. Opportunity's there. Still a few days. Dome Sports Talk Worldwide. And I'm about it, y'all.